Hello friends, in this section, I shall brief you with the concept of one of the incubation tests under seed health testing, that is blotter test, which is meant usually to detect seed-borne fungi. Blotter test is the combination of in vitro and in vivo principles of investigation. Although the experiment is performed in the laboratory, the natural condition of the seed, seedling growth rate and virulence of the inoculum or infection percentage can be determined. Seeds are sown in petri dishes with usually three layers of blotter paper to retain moisture at the time of incubation. Seeds are placed at fixed distance, possibly to avoid neighboring infection. Most of the seeds are incubated for a week at fixed temperature. Plant debris, inert matter, separated during the visual examination of seeds can also be plated to predict the chances of infection by the admixtures. During incubation, incubators should be provided with near UV radiation to stimulate sporulation of the fungi, which assist in identification. Here, 12 hours of light and 12 hours of darkness is adopted as the standard procedure of International Seed Testing Association. The blotter method was developed by Doerr in 1938, which was later included in the International Seed Testing Association rules of 1966. This technique is meant to identify fungi, and it's suitable for cereals, legumes, vegetable seeds, and all kinds of seeds such as forage seeds. Generally, 400 seeds per sample is required for the test. If the seeds are smaller in size, minimum 25 seeds are placed per petri dish and kept for incubation. The core materials required for the blotter test is blotter sheets, distilled water, forceps, pencil, scissors, seeds, petri dishes, and also microscopes after the period of incubation. After incubation, seeds are examined under a low-power stereo microscope with magnification of 50 to 60 times. A stereo microscope enables the observation of fungi as developed on their host in situ in a condition of natural growth, where we can see the mycelial growth, the conidiophores, the conidia, fruiting bodies conspicuously. After incubation, the outer seed near the corner of the petri dish are examined first, followed by seeds in the center of the dish. Each seed is examined, and if fungus is present, marked with initials with the help of a green pencil. For example, if it is Aspergillus, mark it with A. When it's difficult to identify the characters of fungus under stereo microscope, slight preparations are done with lactophenol cotton blue and observed under compound microscope. The number of seeds infected with different fungi are noted and expressed in infection percentage, and it's well suitable for deuteromycete species. Now coming to limitations, fast growing fungi may hinder the growth of slow growing fungi, and hence these are not revealed. Some saprophytes may also grow and impede the recording of parasitic fungi. For more details, please go through the references. Thank you.